You know, one man once said, why do I have to study? Why do I have to read a book? I don't even have the passion to read. Don't we feel like that sometimes?
Yeah.
And you know, another individual, of course, replied to that. He said, well, if someone could record all of his wisdom, if someone can record all of his knowledge, if someone can record all of his life experiences into a single book, I'd be a fool not to read it. And in so many ways, that individual said, if I read that book, not only will I gain knowledge, I will gain wisdom and I will gain experience. And in so many ways, today, there's so many books that are written out there by various wise, smart, and experienced individuals. But you know who's the wisest, smartest, and the most experienced individual? God. And you know, both atheists and believers, you know, we believe that time existed before time. What do I mean? Genesis 1 teaches that in the beginning. Teaching that before that time, there was time that existed. And both Christians and atheists believe that during that time, there was a force that existed, and that force created what is known as the Big Bang. We as Christians believe that force is God. But atheists, of course, they could whatever they wish. And as believers, we believe that this force is personal. And since this force is personal, it decides to record all of his life experiences, all of his knowledge and his wisdom into the Word, which is the Bible right there.
Amen. Amen.
I've been given a simple charge. I've been given a charge, a greater love for personal Bible studies. Let's turn our Bibles to 2 Timothy chapter 3.
Come on, friend.
We're going to see a scripture we've never read in our entire Christian life before. 2 Timothy chapter 3. Pick up verse 16, it says, all scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so the men of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work.
Amen.
You know, this scripture over here simply teaches that the Word of God, the Bible, all comes from God. And it teaches that it's useful for four things. It says it's useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training. Now, I went deeper into this, and I went to find out the Greek words for this. And the Greek word for teaching is actually doctrine. The Greek word for rebuke is proof conviction, basically true conviction. The Greek word for correcting is to straighten up, to reform. The Greek word for training is tutorage, that is to educate, and it's also to nurture or chastening or to purify. Basically, having a greater love for personal Bible study is basically having a greater love for true doctrine. Having a greater love for building up your true convictions right there. Having a greater love to straighten up your faith. Having a greater love to be purified by God.
Amen.
That's what it means to have a greater love for personal Bible study. And the characteristic you need to have, you know, in order for you to be taught, rebuked, corrected, and trained is humility. You see, in order for you to have a greater love for personal Bible study, you gotta get rid of your pride. Pride is coming before God with a full cup. You gotta come to God with an empty cup and let Him fill you up right there. And you know, what's powerful, it says that when you master this, you'll be thoroughly equipped to do some work, right?
No,
it says every good work. And sometimes we ask ourselves a question. We say, hey, why is that I failed so many times in certain areas? It's simply because you've not been thoroughly equipped. You've not thoroughly equipped yourself to overcome your lust.
Come on, bro.
You've not thoroughly equipped yourself to overcome your bitterness.
Come on,
you've not thoroughly equipped yourself to overcome your pride and so forth. And I think a lot of us as disciples, we like to have what is known as a spoon-fed discipleship. And disciple basically means to be a student. And I recall the time when I was a student. I not only just read the single book that, you know, was recommended to me, I read various other books as well that aided into my studies. And I'm just going to keep it very short. I've got some challenge for you. If you have a small Bible like this one over here, which you use for your quiet times, Bible studies, and so forth, I challenge you to get yourself a big Bible like this. I challenge you to get yourself a study Bible where you're able to go deeper into the Word of God. You know, I love study Bibles because...
Come on.
I just want to show you something quickly.
Come on, bro.
Come on, bro.
Study Bibles are incredible. it just gives, it just shows something clear over here. We've got all the kings of Israel and Judah. And it also points out the prophets that existed during the lifetimes of those kings. And it gives you a different mindset when you read all the prophetic books in the Bible. And you get to understand the era and basically everything that we're preaching right there. And I want you to use your smartphones to help you get close to God. What I mean, download an app that helps you get the Greek and the Hebrew words so you can have a deeper understanding of the Word of God right there. And simply, lastly, read commentaries. I challenge you to read commentaries. If you want to have a greater love for your personal Bible studies, go after getting yourself a study Bible, go after using a smartphone to get an app that helps you get Greek and Hebrew words, and read commentaries right there. And that is how we have a greater love for personal Bible studies. Thank you very much.